Let's spring into this video about springs. Hi, I'm Mike. Sometimes parts and components are very similar to each other, but there are key differences between them that result in different applications for each. In each episode of this video series from Radwell TV, we compare parts that are similar to each other, but also have their differences. Today I will be explaining the similarities and differences between a compression spring, extension spring, and a torsion spring. The biggest similarity between these devices is their purpose to pull, push, wind, support, lift, or protect mechanical devices through storing force. A compression spring is an open coil helical wire wound or constructed to oppose a force when compressed. These coil springs can work independently or they can be assembled over a guide rod or fitted inside of a hole. Compression springs operate starting with a force being applied to them. This force causes the spring to compress and store energy. The spring will try to return to its original length, releasing the energy it has stored and pushes back against the force. Compression springs are one of the most common and efficient energy storage devices available. They are found assisting agricultural equipment, assembly lines, industrial robots, paper mills, mechanically actuated valves, and many more. An extension spring is a helically coiled wire designed to provide an opposing force when stretched. Extension springs have loops or hooks on their ends to be attached to components that need to be held together. When the mechanisms they are attached to begin to separate, the springs will try to bring them back together. Storing the energy through the hooks and loop, an extension spring provides a return force to the connected mechanisms. Extension springs are found primarily in manufacturing applications where an opposing force is required by two components, along with everyday applications like a garage door or a trampoline. A torsion spring is a helically wound wire to provide resistance to a twisting or rotating force. Similar to extension springs, torsion springs have arms that are connected to the external components which apply a load to the spring. Torsion springs operate through force acting on the arms which then rotate around the center of the spring. When this occurs, the spring will try to push them back to the original position. As the spring returns to its resting position, it brings the attached parts with it. Torsion springs are found primarily in manufacturing applications for motion control. The biggest difference between these three types of springs are their design construction. Though all three are helically wound, extension springs have hooks or loops, and torsion springs have arms that attach to specific components. Compression springs have no additional design features like hooks, loops, or arms to be fitted to the mechanical device. Due to their design difference, each spring has a different operational movement. Compression springs are pushed under an external force, extension springs are stretched under an external force, and torsion springs are rotated under external force. Though all three springs have the same capability of storing force when under pressure, which one to use depends upon the force or torque needed by the applications and the operational conditions. Thanks for watching this Compare the Parts episode. For information about Radwell, visit radwell.com or connect with us on social media.